Tom, if you could just describe what you felt was the difference between how Kai surfed on his laydown board and how he surfed on his stand-up board.
One of the things I noticed about Kai, and from what I've been told, Kai is a real unique example of a surfer out of jaws, because he's really good on either a prone board or a stand-up. And the stand-up paddling to me is just a more logical approach to big wave surfing, because first of all, they're standing up so they can see better. Second of all, they have much more mobility. It's more critical to be in the right spot at the right time. Kai's stand-up board is basically the same size as his prone board. It is 1 inch wider. I think he told me his board was 10'4" by 23", and Shane Dorian's board is 10'6" by 22". So they're basically the same size board. Kai could stand up on his prone board just as easily as his stand-up board. And then the other thing I noticed is that when the surfers are paddling in, it's all about the drop, obviously, and making it down the face. And by the time they get to the bottom of the wave, they're just trying to regroup and set an edge and try to turn that thing. Whereas Kai is getting in with speed, as we just talked about. So as he's getting into the wave, he's already standing up. He's almost kind of bunny hopping to even drive the board faster. And when he starts to drop in, he's already standing up. And instead of trying to negotiate the drop, he's already like fading and just going into this fast bottom turn, where he's actually looks like he's more surfing a shortboard than a gun, even though it is a gun, you know.
Does he use the paddle, how does he use the paddle?
Yeah, he uses the paddle when he's turning and stuff as a balance pivot point, so forth. And that's what I really noticed was how much more functional his surfing looked on that stand-up, even though it's the same size board as a prone board that they paddle out there.
What about, of course, the holy grail of those stand-up guys at Peahi is getting tubed on that West Bowl. How did he handle it? Obviously this is, I've seen that sequence, that incredible sequence you have of him getting that really nice tube. How did he handle it when it got hollow like that?
Frick, it looked like he was a statue in the barrel. He was solid. He surfed it perfectly. There was no wobbling or I didn't notice anything except just, he just surfed it perfectly.
One thing that I noticed looking at the footage was Kai was actually at the end section was doing like top turns and stuff. Like he was actually turning where most of the guys there on paddling boards had to go straight. I mean, aside from getting in early and giving him that mobility, did you see a sort of a higher level of performance?
I noticed that too, and I think it has to do with just getting in so early and getting set up and getting that initial bottom turn off and being ahead of the game instead of being a little bit behind. Because as you know, that late drop on a gun, you're just trying to maintain control and get to the bottom of the wave. That's your first goal, right?
Uh-huh.
Rather than the stand-up. Seems like Kai is just like, he's already looking down the line. He's already done three turns in his mind before he's even got to the bottom,
So overall, from watching that performance, from your position, having shot so much surfing and having seen so much of the sport evolve, what's your opinion on the place for stand-up paddling and big wave surfing?
I can't wait to see Kai out there on a day where people are starting to say, well, it's not paddleable and it's time for the jet skis, because uh-huh. I think that stand-up is kind of like the step in between a prone surfing and toe surfing. And from what I've seen and heard, Kai is a little bit more gifted on that stand-up in big waves than anyone else that I've seen or heard about. And he's going to be the guy that's going to kind of open some minds to what stand-up paddling can do in bigger waves.
Tom, that was perfect.